Yes. Speak, then. What were they doing? It did not look like it served any purpose. When do they have time to waste on foolishness? They have much to learn. Competency is less exciting, I admit. Study serves better than whatever that was. Why? That may be the difference, then. Kunari are men, not animals. Your priests clearly should have spent more time training you. Then who trained the Emekari? Tamasrans. But the Emekari are not theirs. They belong to the Kunari, not the priesthood. You let your Emekari be raised by them? That explains much. Can we move on? As you wish.
Yes? What can I do for you? Of course. My lady, your mother did not survive. I am so very sorry. I do not wish to burden you any further with this. Both your parents died that day. I must admit, I cannot give you many details. They had already dragged me outside, and I was half conscious, but I saw soldiers dragging your parents' bodies out. The Arl looked at them briefly, gave a sign. The servants took them and put them next to the rest of the bodies. They were burnt along with the rest.
What do you need? Ask away. Have you seen the uniform? It's not only stylish, but well made. I'm a sucker for good tailoring. I keep it hidden under my pillow. Sometimes I'll take it out just so I can hug it fondly and remember the good old days. Brings a tear to the eyes, you know. I'd use my shield if I could, but I think you might actually spot me hiding behind it. You don't really want to know about my being a Templar, do you? It's really quite boring. You know, I like the way you think. But I guess if you're really curious, there's no harm in obliging. I have a couple of interesting looking moles I can show you later too, if you're interested. The truth of the matter is, that I did hate going to the monastery. The initiates from poor families thought I put on airs, while the noble ones called me a bastard and ignored me. I felt like Al-Eman had cast me off, unwanted, and I was determined to be bitter. But I took some solace in the training itself, I guess. I was actually quite good at it. No, I never got that far. I mostly learned about discipline and training my mind to use the abilities that Templars have. It was difficult, but rewarding. I never really felt at home anywhere, though, until I joined the Grey Wardens. And Duncan felt my Templar abilities might be useful when we encountered Darkspawn magic, so I kept it up. What about you? Do you have anywhere you consider home? Right. Stupid of me to ask. I'm sorry. We won't always be traveling like this, you know. Once the war is over, once the Blight is... Well, a time will come when we'll have to think about having a real home again. though that seems like a far ways off. And I suppose the Grey Wardens are gone for good, either way. I suppose you're right. We can create new Grey Wardens, but we'll never get back those we lost. I wonder if it would ever feel the same. Anyhow, now I've sidetracked us. We'd better get back to what we're supposed to be doing right now.
Yes? Something you need? Yes? What's on your mind? Why did you hear this? And you believe everything you hear? Not all minstrels are spies. Most are just singers and storytellers. But some of them are what we call bards. Many use the two words minstrel and bard interchangeably, but to do so in Orlais would cause misunderstanding. Bards are minstrels and more. Spies, as you say. Some say there is a bard order, but I don't think this is true. Many bards work alone or in small groups, doing the bidding of a patron who pays for their services. If there is an organization behind it all, no one knows who they are. What do you think? They infiltrate, steal, sometimes assassinate? It depends on the bard. In Orlais, there is much rivalry amongst the highborn. They fight over land, influence, and the favor of the Empress. But they cannot do this openly because it is impolite, and in public, they wear smiling faces and pretend to be civil. In secret, they plot and scheme to destroy each other. It is a game completely meaningless to anyone but its players. I have revealed too much, it seems, but it doesn't matter what I used to be. It is the past. The excitement of the life wears off very quickly, I'm afraid. I found myself in Ferelden and sheltered from bad weather in the Chantry. And when the storm passed, I just did not want to leave. I like to see the Maker brought me here.
I certainly could, but I won't. I swore to the crows that the things they taught me were to remain a secret. And while, yes, they are already angry at me, I'd rather not push things, you see. You need to learn the arts of the crows in order to slay Darkspawn, do you? You seem to be doing fine as it is. If you are truly insistent, well, let me think about it. The crows are already angry at me, yes? Who knows? Here I am. Oh, this should be good. Go ahead. Well now, I imagine that's a very fair question. Being an assassin after all is a living, at least as far as such things go. I was simply never given the opportunity to choose another way. So if that choice presents itself, why should I not seize upon it? I don't know that I would put it precisely that way. I was but a boy of 7 when I was purchased. For 3 sovereigns, I'm told. Which is a good price, considering I was all ribs and bone and didn't know the pommel of a dagger from the pointy end. The crows buy all their assassins that way. Buy them young, raise them to know nothing else but murder. And if you do poorly in your training, you die. Of course. You compete against your fellow assassins, and those who survive are rightfully proud of it. In Antiva, being a crow gets you respect. It gets you wealth. Gets you women. And men. Or whatever it is you might fancy. But that does not mean doing what is expected of you always. And it means being expendable. It's a cage, if a gilded cage. Pretty, but confining. I fancy many things. I fancy things that are beautiful, and things that are strong. I fancy things that are dangerous and exciting. Would you be offended if I said I fancied you? This is good to know. As for what I'll do in the future, presuming that there is one, I truly can't imagine. It might be interesting to go into business for myself, for a change. Far away from Antiva, of course. For now, naturally, I go where you go. And here I am, happy to be had. Isn't it wonderful how things work out that way? Come now, enough chit-chat. Talking about the crows summons them, you know. Any Antivan fishwife could tell you so.
A ladder so you can get off my back. I'll get on it. Now's better than late. Alright, alright.
I lied to you, you know, about why I left Orle. In a way, I did. But these feelings were triggered by events which I did not tell you about. I didn't feel like talking about it then, what happened to me. Maybe it will affect us, maybe not, but... You should know. I came to Ferelden and the Chantry because I was being hunted in Orle. I was framed, betrayed by someone I thought I knew and could trust. Marjolaine. She was my mentor and friend. She taught me the bardic arts, how to enchant with words and song, to carry myself like a highborn lady, to blend in as a servant. The skills I learned, I used to serve her, my bardmaster, because I loved her, and because I enjoyed what I did. She was a remarkable woman. I cannot fully express the admiration I had for her, or the depth of my affection. I thought I knew her. My devotion to her blinded me to her less than noble attributes. You can say it was my fault. There was a man I was sent to kill. I was to bring Marjolaine everything he carried. I don't know who this man was. She gave me a name and a description, and I hunted him down. I found documents on his body, sealed documents. My curiosity got the better of me. Something told me that I needed to know what was in those letters. Marjolaine had been selling all kinds of information about Orle to other countries, Nivara and Antiva among others. It was treason. Some. But I had always assumed Marjolaine only operated within Orle. This was an unhappy surprise for me. My life as Bard taught me that my loyalties should be kept fluid. My concern was not that she was a traitor, but that her life would be in danger if she was caught. Orle has been at war with so many countries, it takes a harsh view of such things, as I later discovered. I should have left well alone, but I didn't. I had to tell Marjolaine I feared for her life. She brushed aside my concern. She admitted her guilt, but said it was in the past. That is why the documents had to be destroyed, she said. I believed her. I kept believing up till the moment they showed me the documents, altered by her hand to make me look the traitor. Yes, the Orlesian guards. They captured me. Did terrible things to make me confess and reveal my conspirators. It was a traitor's punishment I endured. And at the end of it, all that awaited me was eternity in an unmarked grave. This kills Marjolaine taught me we're good for something at least. I broke free when I saw the opportunity. I did not seek Marjolaine out. If she thought I was coming for her, she would have me caught again. I was tempted to confront her. I was furious, betrayed. But what could I do against her? And so I fled to Ferelden, to the Chantry and the Maker. Ferelden protected my person, and the Maker saved my soul. And that is the reason I am here. The real reason. No more lies between us, at least in this. It feels good to have this off my chest. Thank you for listening and understanding.